Because it's different. Back in the day, you were pregnant. It's in the 70s. You weren't graduating with the pregnancy thing. It's a new generation now. But back in the day, if you were pregnant, you couldn't march across stage. Right? They gave my mom her degree, you know, in the back room somewhere. But she was pregnant, couldn't get it. And that hurt my mom. Right? And so what my mom did was, my mom met somebody in Detroit, got married, moved from Chicago, and she kept that a secret. So mom didn't, you know, that was like, she was embarrassed by that for whatever reason. So when she got married, mom was like, you know, I've always been married, right? My father, who was not my biological father, but who raised me, at six, changed my birth certificate, and they gave me the last name Thomas. I'm not a Thomas. I'm a Monday. But they switched everything up, so I didn't know.
Right, I'm
so
back. Going we're back. Life, welcome to the wrong. Cooks and Books like, Show. Your host, Adrienne Young, and we have got the cooks in the house. You know? We got the people in the house, you all. I have been wanting to interview Mr. Chuck Nolan for some time now, but good things come to those who wait. I remember I had submitted some information to you all, I want to say around December, and I kept saying, it's coming, it's coming. Right. And I was saying to myself, I hope they don't believe I'm just one of those people that just, you know, talk about doing things. But it's an honor to have Cutters, everybody, Cutters of Detroit, representing Detroit. Welcome, Cutters, Mr. Nolan and Shaniqua, thank you so much for coming. Tell me, now I read your bio.
Yes.
Man, you have got it going on. I don't even know where to start. I understand you're going to get into new projects,
that's
but
correct.
We'll talk about that.
Okay.
But let's talk about 10 years ago, your dream,
right.
And why you created Cutters, and what was your mission behind creating it?
Well, first of all, thank you for having us. We really appreciate you having us on the show today. When I first got into the business, I was interested in having a restaurant that catered to us where we serve good quality food at reasonable prices with great service. I thought those things were missing in our community.
You gotta believe
a lot of times
that.
We would go to places, the food was subpar, service was terrible, and I saw that need and I wanted to fill that void in the community.
And let me tell you, because I am a person, believe it or not, sometimes I will go places and it wouldn't even be about the food. It was the way that people treated me.
Absolutely.
And you know, I would say, you know what, I'm never coming back. Your food was superb, but your service sucked.
Right.
But sometimes the food in some places would be terrible. But the people were so kind. I'm like,
that's
you know
right.
what? They make a good drink. I'm going to go back.
Exactly.
But I understand Cutters, you got the package deal. Mm-hmm. You make people feel good, welcome.
Yes.
Like, cheers. Everybody
that's
knows your name.
Exactly. That's
why
what we know.
And then the food. Oh, my goodness. I don't even know where to go. We got a cheddar cheese shrimp baked potato. We got a burger, a mega cheeseburger
yeah,
with
16
like,
ounce bacon
16
cheeseburger. Broccoli and cheese.
Go
then we have a broccoli. You have a broccoli and cheese potato that has shrimp. That has broccoli on it also. And then we have our steak bites, one of our signature dishes that we brought also with
yes,
us.
I see that. I smell it all through. But back to you, the customer service and feeling good. So, 10 years ago, what did you see yourself opening your restaurant in Eastern, in the Eastern Market area?
At that point, I was just leaving the auto industry. I was in the auto industry for about 9 years.
Sure.
And I wanted to go into business for myself. I didn't know what I wanted to do, so I dabbled in a few different things. And like I said, I would go to different restaurants and bars, and I said, there's something missing in our community.
Exactly.
When I found Cutters in the Eastern Market, it was a little bitty ad in a newspaper.
Get out of here.
On a Sunday.
Okay, so it was something like a vision board. Did you say, like, that's going to be mine?
Well, I didn't claim it at that point.
Okay.
I didn't. I read the ad. I called the guy. He gave me the address and the location. And I wasn't familiar. I had heard about the Eastern Market, but I never really had been there. But we had a staple in the Eastern Market, as everybody knows, is Burt's.
Right.
So when I went down, I sat around. I watched it for about 3 weeks. And I said, I'm going to try this. I can make this happen. It was something totally different. There's no dance floor. You know, most of the time you have the bars or restaurants in our community, they cater to more like clubs.
Mm-hmm.
We're more of a restaurant than a club. So I saw a need and I said, I'm going to try this.
Okay. I understand you guys have some, you're about giving back. And I had just said that. Tell us about the cancer awareness event that you all are representing. Can you give us a little bit more information about that?
Yeah, sure. We're this will be our second year. We're part of the Susan Coleman Cancer Walk they do every year. Last year we were chosen to be their food provider for their top fundraisers, and that was at I believe the Opera House last year.
Okay.
So we're putting our team together. Dorothy Pirtle, who isn't here today, she
was. Look, a shout out Dorothy.
Yeah, shout out to Dorothy.
Dorothy made this interview happen.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. Dorothy
professional.
She's awesome.
You know, and I love it.
Yeah, she's awesome.
I mean, even to the very minute, yes. I want to say the show starts at 5.
Right.
Dorothy was texting me to make sure everything was
Dorothy.
Said
that's
our
Dorothy.
Yeah. So, yeah, great person on your side.
Absolutely. We have a great team, great staff. And so we got involved with Coleman. My grandmother, before she passed away, had cancer. So that was something near and dear to me. And Dorothy, again, helped us put together with Susan Coleman last year. And this will be our second year participating. She's now formulating our team to walk in the event this year.
Oh, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That cancer is something else, you know?
But
you know
what?
I'm glad that we as African Americans are doing our part.
And taking part, that's right.
You usually see other people doing it. I'm just glad that you see us doing the walks and wearing the pink ribbons. I mean, even the kids in my school this year, we had on the pink shirts. Even the boys didn't care about having on pink shirts.
That's right.
They were like, you know,
it's for
my grandmother,
exactly,
auntie, et cetera. But back to this good food. So let's say at lunchtime, I'm busy. And you know, a lot of people lose business at lunchtime. Do you have a phone number?
Yes, we do.
And can people call in and pre-order? Because I know some places don't offer that.
Yes,
but,
you can.
But Cutters does that.
Yes. Actually, like
you can call in and pre-order your food. You can also fax us your order.
You can
We have online orders. And we tell our customers to call your order in if you want to sit in or dine. Dine in or take it out and we'll have it ready for you either or. Because some people, at lunchtime, you're always in a rush. Our motto is 30 minutes or less like Domino's because everybody's busy.
Right.
For lunch, so we like to get you in, have you a good time, eat your food, and you still have time.
So,
yes, it's worked for us.
You can't beat class and professionalism.
Yes, you can't beat it.
So I read your bio. And what is this I hear about you taking it to the next level with butchery and actually importing and exporting meats? Want to talk about that more?
Yeah, just a little bit. I'll touch on a little bit. We're in the process of negotiating to buy a meat company.
Wow.
So deal isn't done yet, but we're working on it.
Well, I'm going to claim it because I was like, wow. And you're also a member of the Michigan Bars Association.
Yes, I'm the president.
He's the president.
You're not only the client.
He's the president of the
You're the president.
I was fortunate enough by the members in January for them to elect me as president.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You are, you know, people talk about it, but Chuck, you seem to be doing it, and you seem to have such a welcoming and humbling spirit.
Very much so.
And that's just so good because, you know, sometimes we, all of these accomplishments, we forget about where we come from and forget to give back, and you just seem to keep doing more and still remain, you know, approachable.
Yeah, he's
and
very
I love
humble.
That about you.
He's an awesome person to work for.
And then Shaniqua is backing it up.
Yeah,
she says you
9 years with him.
Nobody stand with nobody 9 years and working for them because they're, you know, people are leaving jobs left and right. But your team, everybody that I spoke with, and they love Cutters. There, I mean, from IG to Facebook. I know when I had mentioned the event, Chuck, instantly, we're so glad we know about it. We've been talking about it. So, you know, you just seem
networking.
To have a partnership, family. You know, there's nothing like that when it comes to business.
Thank you. I appreciate the credit you gave me earlier, but I got to give that credit to my parents.
Okay. And I just said that earlier. It's funny that you said, you know, we had a young lady on here today. I wish you guys could have been here. This baby was 12. It's 12. No, 13. Mm-hmm. Author of 10 books.
Oh,
and
wow.
On the publishing company.
Awesome.
And get this, the baby... She's so ahead of her time, you could get the books in Spanish.
Wow.
African-American young lady. So I was saying, you know, just imagine what you could do if you push your kids.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you see that they, it's something that enlightens them and they grasp the concept. And then you just kind of like push it, you know, for the next Tiger Woods or for the next Beyonce.
That's
you
right.
see that in there and you give them what they need to go forward. But on the kids' note, tell me a little. I've also read in your bio about the things that you're doing with the kids. Tell us a little bit more about that because, our kids. I'm a teacher and I'm just going to leave it at that.
I sit on the Wayne County Youth and Senior Board Foundation. So we give a lot, we give back to the community a lot. Part of what we do at the Michigan Black Bar Owners Association is we give scholarships to kids every year to go to college.
Man, is that information, do you have the website? Can we say that right now?
Absolutely.
Children, parents, Detroit, the world, if you're listening to this website.
Our website is mbboa.com for Michigan Black Bar Owners Association.
Well, you know what? Our time is just about up. But if you guys want to come back,
thank you very
much. Thank you so much for having us.
But guess what? I'm coming over. You guys is when I'm get it together. I'm coming over there because I need a little happy hour.
Okay.
In my life,
we'll take care of you. Definitely, we'll take good care of you.
So tell the audience, Detroit, the world, Mr. Nolan, your website again.
Our website for Cutters is cuttersEasternMarket.com.
It's been a pleasure having you guys on.
Thank you so much
for having us.
Well, you have to know this is a partnership. This is only the beginning.
Okay.
All right.
We appreciate it
so much.
Well,
thank you for listening to UrbanNationRadio.com. I'm your host, Adrian Young, with the Cooks and Books Show. It's been a pleasure having you, and I look forward to being with you again next Thursday, May 1st. Take care.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.